The universe right now is about 14 billion years old, okay? Precisely 13.8 billion years. So up to 400,000 years from the birth of the universe was opaque to radiation because electron and protons were separated in ionized form. Okay? And in that medium, the electromagnetic waves cannot travel. So what we can see today in the sky, the cosmic microwave background radiation, is the image of the universe that is when the universe was 400,000 years old. Gravitational wave doesn't have this restriction. Okay, so if you could observe gravitational waves from the early universe, okay, they are not affected by the fact that the universe was ionized. Okay, because ionized universe, gravitational wave can still propagate through ionized universe. Okay. So by observing gravitational waves from the early universe, we may be able to probe universe at a much earlier reaching, right? So that's the general idea of why gravitational waves may be useful. Okay. But to actually observe gravitational waves from the early universe is, of course, it requires a lot of effort. And that certainly the current LIGO experiments cannot do that.
So string theory can be experimentally proven only if we get the gravitational waves from the beginning of the universe or from the birth.
Yeah, if we could really get the gravitational waves from the very beginning of the universe, I think we'll see everything. Right? I mean, there are string-like structure. In principle, that encodes all the information about the high energy. I mean, whatever you could do by high energy experiment, if you could really observe the beginning of the universe, we would see all those.
So far, but string theory is only a mathematical model.
Yes, indeed. So far, string theory is a mathematical model, which, as I said, has many different solutions. And in each of those solutions, we see that it, of course, always has gravity. And it also has the forces like strong, weak, and electromagnetic force, which we know are there in nature.